Hello and welcome back. Today I have a very little but powerful receiver, and it is the SI4732. And this little receiver is actually based on this one chip, and also has a little Arduino inside. And the receiver goes from almost zero, like I don't know, 200 kilohertz, up to a all the way up to 30 megahertz. So it even covers also CB band if you're interested in that. And depending on your firmware or libraries that you use, it can actually go from 64 megahertz up to 108. So it stops just before the air band. And yeah, you can buy these in AliExpress or Amazon, eBay, and Banggood. I will put some links below. And it's also sold as the AT20, ATS20. And there is also, I think, a 25. It's a little bit bigger display. And the cool thing is, it's kind of open source. And there is one guy who did a lot of work on the libraries and the code. And that is PU2CLR. And he even put this code out there. So if you have an older version, I also want to show you how you can update this. So hopefully, I don't break it myself. Let's have a closer look first. Well, I have seen some reports from people telling them they received it in a bubble envelope only. Well, I received it in this nice box, and so it was well protected. Shipping was kind of fast actually, and it even comes with a USB cable, and that's nice because they used an older USB type, as you can see. So, but it all came with it. It even comes with a little battery, and I've been playing for a few days, and it is still charged. So it does have a good charge. The controls are very basic. Also, that depends also on the firmware that you run, because here you can say band plus, band minus. Here you step through your pre-programmed bands, but this one already has the latest firmware. So if you do band, then you can just switch through your band with your encoder. The encoder is just a standard encoder, so you need to be a bit careful when you turn the knob. Don't go crazy on it, because at some point you will break your encoder. Volume, it's the same. You push the volume button, and then you can just scroll through it. The step, you can change. Auto gain control on off. And you have some bandwidth you can change. You can step through the modes AM, FM, SSB. So basic controls, very nice. In the back, well, you have here your USB. It says USB charge, but it is also the back of your Arduino. So if you program, and it doesn't mean that it becomes an SDR receiver or anything. It is just your Arduino. So probably it's just the CH340 or the CH341 that just emulates a serial port. So, but you also charge your battery with this. On off, you have here the LED for the charge. I can show you that already. I think it's red when empty and green when it's fully charged. I never have it seen red, by the way. So maybe it was already charged when they send it, or it's one color, I don't know, but it is now green. So that's it. You have here your headphone, and the cool thing is, if you use it on FM mode, so in the higher frequencies, you can use your headphone as an antenna. So then you can actually put it in your pocket, and but you can also use an antenna like this, the telescope. And and here you have also your FM AM button, but this is actually the higher frequency, no? The 64 to up to 108, and here you go, 30 and below. That's quickly the controls. Well, Silicon Lab made this chip, and he actually made a very nice chip because everything is almost integrated. As you can see here in the FM band, you can really go from 64 to 108. But I know that the older firmware just started at 84, I think. And with the latest software that is now released, you can use the full span of the chip. As you can see, there is really no air bond. This is actually quite interesting because I can see here it only goes up to 26 MHz, while I have seen in the list of the latest firmware that it actually would go up to 30 MHz. So if there is some stretch here, maybe there is also some stretch here, and we can maybe find also air bonds. I'm just gonna switch it on, and I was actually surprised about the speaker quality on FM mode. I already pre-recorded something in my office. Let me switch it on. Here you can see the library version number 307B. I think there is already a newer one. Well, no problems with the commercial radios. And you can just go very loud. I was actually surprised by the sound. I think I should get my mini whip and see if I can get some lower frequencies also. I just took my little mini whip. That's cool because this one goes from 10k up to 30 MHz, so this is great for the lower band, and in the switch in the back it's called AM. So we select the AM and we connect the mini whip. I think this was around $30. I can also leave a link of that. And I forgot to mention these one are, I think they are between 50 up to 80 depending what store you buy it. And I bought it in discount, so I had really below $50 at my door. So that is really, really, really cool. Okay, well, I'm not sure if it's very insensitive or I'm doing something wrong, but there is not much you can do. I'm here on 920 kilohertz, and I don't hear too much. Auto gain control is on. I don't put the attenuator on. I can change a little bit the bandwidth, but as you can hear, it's completely dead at 920. But when I put it on my old NASA, it is full power. Oh, 920 is it. In full power, and this one doesn't hear anything. Oh, clearly my receiver has a problem. In the normal FM band, it is really below 1 microvolt, and I put it on my Marconi, and on the lower band, when you put the switch to SSB or to AM on the lower frequency, so between 0 and 30 MHz, its sensitivity is around 20 millivolt, which is crazy. So I'm looking at the schematic. It could be something with the LNA, or there is a wire loose. So I will just open it up. Well, it will be nice to see also what is the inside. Then we can probably see the Arduino. I think it was a Nano. But it's a pity that the lower band doesn't work, because the FM is really good. So then I need to send it back. No. Let me take out the speaker. Okay, I opened it. And here, with the antenna switch, I thought, oh, okay, I see it, the chip is missing. But they put it here on the bottom. And we can get the microscope to have a better look. But with a sensitivity like this, I think I need to send it back. Because this is not good. And indeed, if you look here, it is the Arduino Nano. Well, that's very clear. That is the Arduino Nano. All the connections there. This is a TDA, so that's probably audio amplifier. And let me go to the bottom. This should be that SI chip. Yes, 4732A10. But all the soldering seems good. So, oh, not really. What happened here with this pin? Okay, that could be something. Well, I clean it now a little bit with IPA, and it does look a lot better. I will show you with the close-up, and then I will just close it, and we try again. So I took a little cutting stick and with the IPA, and I clean it. So it wasn't a solder problem, it just was really some oxidation of dirt. So now it's all clean, I'd like to try it again. Okay, put it back together, all clean. It still doesn't work, and I look at the schematic and I will show you, and it's just directly inserted into the chip. So yeah, probably one part of the chip is missing, but maybe it's a great chance to just do an upgrade because it's already broken. So I have the device right here with the USB. I switch it on, then I always go to my device manager, because I would turn the volume down a little bit, and I usually get my device manager just to see what port it will create. Well, I already have the CH430 driver, so that is usually not a problem, but it's always a guess what COM port it's going to be. So I'll just plug it in right now. Yes, and it becomes it's indeed the CH340, and it becomes a COM3, so we use that for Arduino. Okay, well, this is an old setting still, because here I'm still on the WeMOS from my other project. So, but first let's see if we have all the libraries. So we need to go to the library manager, and then we need the library for the SI. And then we need, then we take the latest library here. You can see it is for all these chips, so we need to install that one. We just take the latest version just to be sure. So that will be installed. And then we also need the libraries for the display. And this takes a while. Okay. We need the library for the display, that is the Tiny4, and then we should have, yeah, both of these. And we install the fonts. I think then we have all the dependencies, and then we going to open the sketch. So open, here it is, I have some examples. I downloaded this from the website, I will leave the link also there. Examples, kits, AliExpress, Chinese latest version, and we open it. Okay, then we need to see if we selected the right board, because I need to change the board manager. No, I already have the board, I just need to select the boards. Arduino Nano. Then old bootloader. Then the port was 3. And now we're just gonna try it. We can verify the code. If the libraries are missing, it should complain. It's not complaining. Let's send it to the device. It will again check everything and compile. Meanwhile, I can maybe show what is happening on the oh, it is already done. It just rebooted very quickly. So the update seemed to have worked. Let's see if we start it, if it already shows the new version. Yes, it says now 307D. I think we had B. And let's do a quick test if it's still functioning. So, well, that was a pity that the AM bound, as they call it, was not working, but the FM is working very well. I have another one coming also from Banggood that has a white knob. Don't know why that one is white and this one is black. So we can see that when I receive that. I will need to start a dispute for this one. I would have liked to show you a lot more, but yeah, the bond was broken. It was a great opportunity though to show you the upgrade process, how easy it is if you follow the correct steps. Install the library, select the right board, and you just flash it and it works. And we did a successful update, so that was great. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.